The other day, I was having a lot of trouble in falling asleep. I was tossing and turning in bed, despite being quite tired and really needing that sleep. It occurred to me that this is often a case with me. I started wondering that what might be the reason. And just like most of the millennials, for an instant answer, I turned to my friend Google, who was just a tap away. The reasons I came across with were excessive consumption of coffee, erratic sleep cycle, and consuming certain kind of foods, but none of them was the case with me. I scrolled on and was intrigued when I encountered the fact that the placement of my bedroom or the direction of my bed could also affect my sleep. Yes, I am talking about Vastu Shastra, or the ancient Indian science of architecture. My interest in architecture kindled in me the desire to get deeper into this topic. And thus, today I, Prasoon Sapra, a student of class 12th, am here to deliver a talk on the nexus of science and architecture. How fascinating it is that architecture affects our subconscious. We may not realize, but there is a profound influence of the structures around us and the ones that we inhabit. There is a great connection between the science of architecture and the psyche of ours. In today's busy world, where we have restless schedule and are mostly out of time, the tiny gadgets sticking on our wrists help us a lot. But even after being a smart invention of 21st century, they often fail and stop working. However, the 800 years old temple of Konark has never ever missed a second since 13th century and is always on time. It has 12 stone guard wheels that represent the 12 months of a year, which also act as sundials. The exact time of the day can be calculated by just seeing the shadow cast by those wheels on the ground. Unbelievable, isn't it? Unmatchable is the level of science applied, and that too back then 800 years ago. Jantar Mantar at Jaipur is another architectural marvel that is a complex of 19 astronomical instruments which are still running and being used for teaching and calculations. How astonishing it is that centuries ago, our ancestors developed a kind of architecture that is enduring, cosmic, and geometric at the same time. The next destination to which I am taking you all is the one that is printed on our new 100 rupee note, the Rani Ki Vav. This is an outstanding example of subterranean stepwell construction. Water crisis looms large upon the humanity today, and efforts are being made to save this resource, which is nothing short of the nectar of life. Rani Ki Vav was built in 11th century in the arid region of Gujarat, highlighting the sanctity of water. It also served as a huge reservoir that could soothe the parched throats during a long drought. The journey which I, along with you all, made through these wonders is just a drop in the ocean of charismatic structures. Thousands of them still remain there as the hallmarks in different domains of architecture. Sadly, today we observe a stark contrast between the older and newer buildings. While the former were built strictly in adherence to architectural principles, never compromising on essentials like ventilation, inflow of natural light, and open spaces, the latter are built with a myopic vision and lack most of these necessities. Keeping in mind the various environmental problems that the human civilization is facing these days, we need to rethink and redefine the way we build our structures. There are five basic pillars on which the great edifice of Vastu science of architecture stands. They are examination of site, that is Bhu Pariksha, orientation, that is Dik Nirnaya, planning of various components, that is Pad Vinyas, followed by proportion, measurement, as well as aesthetics. These principles of Vastu are based on the movement of celestial elements such as sun, moon, planets, and their effects on us. They are also derived on the basis of special characteristics and influence of the elements of universe such as the magnetic pull, gravitational effect, heat and light of the sun, including the effects of its ultraviolet and infrared rays on us. Since these principles are based on the natural observations, they can be considered as fundamental and relevant in any era. I used to wonder that why people give so much importance to north and east facing plots. I got to know that the reason behind this is the sun and its rejuvenating rays. As the sun rays are a rich source of vitamin D, doors and windows are kept in east direction so that when the sun rays penetrate into the house, they bestow their benefits to the inmates. And I also got to know that the reason behind my improper sleep was that I slept with my head in the north direction. And due to the pressure caused on the brain by the magnetic pull of the earth, my sleeping cycle got disturbed. So, if you are sailing in the same boat, try checking the placement of your bedroom. The entire universe, including our body, is composed of five basic elements: air, fire, earth, water, and space, also known as the Panch Mahabhut. The fundamental principle of Vastu is to maintain a balance between these five elements and the structure for happiness and comfort. My visit to my great-grandmother's house was something I used to look forward to as a child during the summer days. But today I recall that how we never needed any ACs or coolers even during peak summers. The secret behind this is the high ceiling with many ventilators and thick walls that naturally kept the temperature inside several degrees cooler. It is scientifically proven that the specialized cells in the hippocampal region of our brains are attuned to the geometry and arrangement of the spaces we live in. Angans or center courtyards were integral to the older Indian houses as open spaces make humans feel more relaxed. Not just angans, but wind towers, roof terraces, and stone lattices known as jalis allow air to circulate freely throughout the building and make natural light available in abundance, thereby acting as a great method of climate control. The buzzword today is sustainable architecture, the core values of which are equity, sufficiency, identity, and resilience. Climate responsive design, use of sustainable material, and water harvesting are integral to this concept. And it is heartening to know that the descent of all the fundamental principles can be traced back to the older Indian houses. Indian architecture's transcendence is so intense that merely words cannot elucidate it and quotes cannot delineate it. Civilization sprouted and decayed. Empires rose and fell. Kingdoms emerged and declined. Governments came and went. But what remained unrivaled and withstood the fury of time are these divine creations, which are a testimony of our ancient intellect. Environment-friendly buildings that are resource efficient throughout their life cycle are the call of the day. Design, construction, maintenance, and eventual demolition, if required, are a pressing need. So, as the world heads toward modernization, we must borrow from our ancient wisdom and gift ourselves a future where urbanization strikes a chord with nature and attains a perfect balance. Thank you.